Now I'm going to be doing a demonstration speech on how to make guacamole from scratch. So the first thing you're going to need is 2 avocados. They're supposed to be ripe, but mine aren't because I fall from the other day. And then you're going to need, you can get like salt or anything, but this is like guacamole like mix, so it has like a whole bunch of like different things in it. I don't know. A little bit of spices, lime, half a lime, and then you're gonna need cilantro, and then half a red tomato. So the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna cut open the avocados. The best way to do that is just go down the center around it, and then you're gonna twist it because there's a pit in the middle. And to remove the pit, you're going to take your knife, go like that, and it should just come right out like that. And you can just throw the pit away in the garbage because you don't need that. And fun fact, if you want to grow avocados, you can plant the pit in dirt, wet like soil, and bury it, and then it will grow avocados, like an avocado tree thing. So you want to do that. So you're just going to cut both, move the pit. There's probably a better way and safer way to do this, but you know. Yeah. Okay, well, if it doesn't come out like that, then just take a spoon. Go like that, and it works perfectly. Okay, the next thing you're gonna do is score the avocados, which means you're just gonna go put little lines through it because it helps get it all out. And you're gonna do that to all of your avocados, and it works pretty well. And then, got 2 more. Also, a little fun fact about avocados. You can give them to your dog. They're safe for dogs. Fun fact. So next, you're going to want to scoop all of that on the shell. You don't need that either. Makes like a decent amount of guacamole. So pretty big avocados, I would say. Oh yeah, before this, you want to wash your hands to be clean and sterile. You know, you don't want to give germs to people because that's gross. Okay, now that I have it into this little bowl. I actually do not have a fork. No, that is that. But you can kind of like mash it, I guess. But don't do it to the point where it's like all mashed up. Because if you want like chunky guacamole, which is better than gross smooth guacamole. It works better if you have a fork, so I prefer just to or rather than a spoon. So if you kind of have it mixed up like that, you should probably put in the little smaller chunks because that's big, but whatever. So the next thing you're gonna do is cut the lime. So wipe off the lime for your microphone. Cut the lime in half. Don't don't hurt yourself doing this, okay? You only need half a lime for this, so I'm gonna do the smaller half. You can squeeze the lime in there. You're supposed to do like a tablespoon or a teaspoon, but that's pretty much the amount. Next, take your tomato, your half of your tomato. Okay, does not smell good. And you're gonna cut that up into little pieces, or however big you want the tomato chunks. I don't really like tomatoes, so. Be careful, with knives, they can hurt you and cut you and give you boo-boos. You don't want that. So just cut the tomatoes however big you want them. You want a decent size. Put that in there. I'm gonna cut the rest of it. The stems, those aren't good. I mean, you can eat them, but they're not very good. So I'm just going to cut a little bit off. I probably won't use all of it. It's best to use, if you have kitchen scissors, it's best to use kitchen scissors with this because it goes into smaller, tinier pieces. But you kind of just cut it, but then you like rip it at the same time, if that makes sense. Because this cilantro is pretty good. You can rip it up with your hands. It makes it a lot easier for something like this. But yeah, kitchen scissors makes it into tiny pieces, which is good. And cilantro is usually, it's harder to cut because it's thinner and leafier. So just rip that up with your hands, I guess, if you want to. It usually is pretty small, like in salsas and stuff, or like in guacamole, but it doesn't really matter, I guess. It's your own preference. Okay, so I'm gonna put some of that in there. And then I'm gonna just stir that up. Another little fun fact, California leads the production and growing avocados. So if you're in California, you guys can get yourself a nice avocado. Fun fact. Another thing, the health line, yeah, like I said before, avocados are really good for you. And healthline.com says there's many benefits to eating avocados, and they help with like heart disease and like growing pains. They help with that. So overall, avocados are very good for you, so you should eat more avocados. Like there's a bunch of big pieces in here, so you just want to like chop those up or something. And so it should be looking like that so far. And if you want, you can put like onions in there or like any type of vegetable really that goes good with that. And the last thing or some salts and peppers and other spices. Next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add this. It's kind of your own preference. You're supposed to add like a tablespoon to 2 tablespoons, but You can do whatever you want. So I'm just gonna drizzle some of that on until I think it's good. And I'm gonna stir that around. Make sure it's all nice and blended so you can enjoy it in every bite you have. And that is your guacamole.